In this tutorial, we're gonna create this map. For this, we need two things. First, empty map with borders. I used a map of Switzerland. Second, data that has numeric values that's gonna color our map. In this map, I used amount of COVID virus in wastewaters of Switzerland. And these two data must have identical columns for matching so that we can merge it together. In a nutshell, that's it. But I'm going to show you how to do it step by step. Empty maps can be downloaded from this website. I will now search Switzerland. Now I have the download links down here. Let's see how it looks. This one is for the main border. Second one is for canton border. You can see the source information also here. The other links are for smaller administration level, which I don't need for this map in this tutorial. I'm gonna download Canton Border, which is administration level 1, and save it in my working directory. Next, we bring the numeric values that's gonna color our map. I can get it from this website. It's an official website from Swiss government. It has basically every information about COVID in Switzerland. You can download registry of each cases, test, vaccine, it's all here. But for our map, I want to get numbers about COVID virus in wastewater. In case, if you're interested about the study, the references are in the description box. There are also some links on the screen. Here you see that there is already a map created, but this is in the administration level 2. Of course, they show it like this because these are the places they have sampled, but I want to aggregate it into canton level, which is administration level 1. To do that, I'm gonna first click on the table and just manually copy this table and pass it on Excel sheet. This is not the best way to get any data, but specifically for this map, it was a better option for me. Of course, the manual copy and paste caused a slight problem here. Column names are moved. I just fixed it. Now it's perfect. And now I'm going to save it in my working directory with the name Wastewater COVID. So now I have my two data, I can start working in R. First, I'm going to call required packages. Among these packages, tmap is the one we're going to use to draw our map. Now let's import the geodata, or we can call it geoboundaries data. First, I name it boundaries CH1. And we'll use readogr function from rgdal package to import our geodata. Here, first argument is the file path, then the second argument is the layer name, which I can get it from this folder. Let's check what's in it. It's a list file with three components. The one I'm interested in is the data. Inside the data, there's a bunch of columns. There's a column with abbreviation of canton names. This column will be used to merge with the wastewater data. We can also check it in console. Notice that to call a component of a list, I use @, not a $. Here is the result. There's the column with the canton names. I will now import the wastewater data, and the imported file will be saved in an object called COVID viral load. So let's check it. This column is the abbreviated version of the canton name. This will be used to merge with the geodata. Another important column is the amount of viral load in each city. But here's the problem. Because of this percentage sign, R reads it as a character column. So we need to fix that and convert it to a numeric column so that R can make some calculation. and then we will aggregate these numbers to each canton. Let's check the column type at the glimpse function. As I said, this is a character column. Let's make this change step by step. First, we need a new column, and in this new column, percentage sign will be removed. Then we will have to change the comma with dots, and then finally, we will convert this column to numeric. I will check it now. Here at the end of there is a numeric column named viral load. Let's aggregate this table into cantons. What I'm telling now to R is to group this data by cantons and calculate the average in each group and assign this number to a new column, mean viral load. Let's check this new table. It looks almost perfect. One small change to be made. I will show you what it is. Let's go back to our geodata. Here in this data, front of each canton name, there is a CH. So we have to make it exactly the same. That's why I use now past function to glue the CH to each canton name. Now we have two identical columns in each data, which means it's now ready to be merged. I'm going to name the merged data map water. We will use a merge function from SP package. It's a special function for merging a geodata. In its argument, we have to give the name of the data and column names we are matching. So we have our merged data. Everything looks same, but you see here one more column named mean viral load is added. We can also check it in the console. Here is our column. That means we can now create our map. We're going to use tmap package. In tmap package, first function to draw a map is always a tm shape. Here we give the name of our merged data, which is map water. Then just like ggplot, I will start to specify the components. I want to see the borders. That's why I typed tm borders. So you see here all canton borders of Switzerland. Now let's color this map with our contaminated wastewater data. I use tm fill function. In call argument, we give the column name. It's mean viral load. Then in the palette argument, we specify the color scale. I choose grayscale. Here, our map is basically done, but I want to change the color. You can type palette explorer from tmap tools to see the name of palette. Then the interactive dashboard with many color options will appear. I will choose this red-pink combination. Looks great, but a bit too sharp and The legend looks funny, so let's change that. I reduce the transparency by reducing the alpha and give a title to the legend. We can also change the position of the legend. You can go to the documentation of tmap package and find explanation of each function, each argument in detail. For example, let's see the arguments of tm layered function. Down here we have a couple of options for legends. I will use some of it in my map now. So let's make the legends. Let's make legend outside. Also position it bottom of the map. And we can also play a bit with the font size. I think this map looks good for me. Let's save this map now. To do that, I save my map in object called map water 1. I will use tm save function. Be aware that if you just use normal export function from RStudio, then you might have problem with the resolution and size of the image. That's why it's much better to use tm save function. It will save very optimal image with very good resolution. You can see the file in our folder. This is the map that we saved. One more thing I can show you is an interactive mode. It's very easy. All you have to do is just call tmap mode function and set it up in a view mode. Then you have to call your map object. Now our map is interactive and you can navigate. I hope it was useful. If you have a question or comment, let me know in the comment section, and see you in the next video.